Let's get this one opened and see what we got. So first thing you notice, it comes in a box. And it's a little bit sturdier than the box that Fight for Soul came in. Right, but some of them do get damaged in transit from overseas. So everything just slides right out of the box. Move the box for now. And let's see what we got. So first, let's start with the historical background. And it is, I believe, 32 pages. It is 52 pages of history and designer notes on the battle. Lots of color photos. I'll try to keep this short. Describing the units involved. The actual leaders involved. Then a little bit of Cholm then and now. Fascinating. This is great bedtime reading right here. All right. So then we get to the rule book. So the rule book is 32 pages, and it deals with all the rules you'll need for the scenarios, all the rules you'll need for the campaign games, including some things that are extremely unique. I haven't seen them anywhere except in the Kampfgruppe Scherer modules, including multi-construction buildings, so stone on the ground floor and wooden upstairs, prisons with some unique cellar rules to represent the jail cells, I imagine, the gliders, the gutted buildings. Of course, we've seen that before, but this might have been one of the first places. And there's something to do with the snow sangers, so, and the ability to be hip in the snow sangers. I hope I'm saying that right. Anyway, 32 pages describing all the things you'll need to play, including the drop canisters, the supply dumps. So that's the rules, 32 pages of that. Then we come to the maps. Now the maps, I'll just open one of these up, but there are four of these maps. Two representing the springtime. This is a spring map. As you can see, the spring, lovely spring colors. I'll try to get all of this in here if I can, but it is quite large. And this is just one of them. That's showing the Lovat River. So I believe this this battle is comprises of the east and west sectors, and try to defend through that. So we've got one, two spring maps, one, two winter maps. Now, the maps are identical, except, of course, for the fact that one is a winter map and one is a spring map, but the by special rules, the level of the river is different. And also, a lot of the buildings are now destroyed in the springtime because the winter comes first. So let me try to find a great example of that, which, embarrassingly, I cannot find, but here we go. So this, for example, in the wintertime, here we have, I believe that's the prison, and it has a roof. Here in the springtime, it has no roof. Here we have some buildings that existed in the wintertime. Here are some buildings that no longer exist in the springtime, because they've been destroyed over the winter's fighting. So that's a nice little change-up, unique little feature of that. So we don't have to mark those rubble counters for each one by SSR. They're just that way. Then we get to the scenarios. So we have 15 different scenarios. And I won't go through each one, but there's plenty of variety. There's night, there's long ones. This is 12 turns, and then there's some short ones. Boy, this is pretty big. This is kind of like, I think, the last bid of Kampfgruppe Scherer. So, and then you have some teeny tiny ones, 4.5 turns, 6.5 squads. then it keeps going. Alright, then we get to the campaign games. Now there's two campaign games. One takes place, the first one takes place in the wintertime. That'll be the early battle. And it comes with all the fun stuff to make this easy. And something I want to mention that I really like about Kampfgruppe Scherer and Le Franc Tireur in particular is they give you scenario cards for the campaign games. So it's not just a little list of stuff and then you gotta go look it up. You actually see what you start with other than what you're purchasing. So we have that. This is all campaign game one. Stuff to make your life easy. Then you have map inserts. Not sure why that one is there. And then player aids, rosters to be photocopied. Then we have campaign game two, and notice it is the springtime map. So, ooh, riverboats. All right, well, rafts. That should be fun. All right, and then last but not least, we have the counter sheet. Now, there is one counter sheet that comes with Kampfgruppe Scherer, and on it we have transports, Ju-52s, gliders, Messerschmitts, Focke-Wulfs, and some Russian airplanes I don't know the names of, some Matildas, snow sangars that I mentioned, Germans in winter camo, Russians in winter camo, commissars, supply drops, walking wounded. So, all very useful counters. All right. So there you have it, and I did not mention, but should have been the first thing I mentioned, this is a product by Le Franc Tireur, and the designer of this product is Andy Hershey, and that's it for Kampfgruppe Scherer, Shield of Cholm. Now let's move on to the player's guide. So the player's guide has 8 regular scenarios that go with the maps in Kampfgruppe Scherer. Here are those 8 scenarios, but they also have one solitaire scenario. So that makes 9 scenarios total, and that adds a lot of fun to it. Here's a night scenario. All right. Then we come to what's actually inside. So the book itself is 60 pages, 60 pages of goodness. There is the historical analysis. There's Commissar Hershey. So there is the historical analysis, the strategic and tactical considerations. Then they have analysis of 5 of the scenarios, I believe, 4 of the scenarios. And then they have an analysis of the campaign game and the terrain, breaking down the terrain and the considerations by East and West, so how to play the East game, how to play the West game. And then, finally at the end, everybody's favorite, 5 days in May, campaign game 2, and this will be a replay between Xavier and Frederick. Xavier, of course, is Cologne of Le Franc Tireur. And lots of photos of the campaign game replay, lots of analysis. We have a neutral commentator. And I will not tell you the outcome. Keep you in suspense on the edge of your seat. One of these guys won the campaign game, so that's it for Kampfgruppe Scherer Player's Guide. Now, before we wrap it up, I just want to make mention of the book Besieged by Jason D. Mark, and I've been meaning to get this book for years, and the price tag was so heavy, I said, you're going to regret it. I think I paid $80 or $90 for it. And I do not regret it for a second. It is, I didn't realize it was this big. It was over 500 pages and photos and maps and day-by-day recounting of the battle from both the German and the Russian perspective. And small print, so this will take me, ooh, got a dollar back. No, that's my bookmarks. And as thoroughly researched as any book I've ever read. Just wonderful, wonderful book. So if you get a chance to read it or pick it up, I can't recommend it enough. And it'll really give you the itch to play the game. So there you have it. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy it.